Oh yeah, what's up everybody? Welcome to another stream here at the Den of Nerds Live. A Monday, and we get a nice little Hawkeye trailer drop. We're going to break that down. We're going to talk about why I'm personally so excited for this show. I'm really, really into it, and I think there's a lot of surprises sort of hidden in the show. We're going to talk about the vibe of the trailer, some of the things revealed, a little bit about that comic book run, the Matt Fraction, David Aja comic book run, which, by the way, I just want to say right away, we're going to be doing a stream at noon, as we usually do with the members. So if you're a Nerdvenger member, we'll be streaming at noon. We're going to read at least the first issue of that Hawkeye run from 2012 so that I can kind of take you guys through it and show you why I love that run so much, why I think it's going to be so fun to revisit some of those themes and ideas in the MCU show. So stay, or I guess come back rather, for that if you're a Nerdvenger member. It's going to be really, really cool. But we're also going to go over some of the other crazy Marvel things and Star Wars things and just nerdy things that dropped over the weekend. You know, there's rumors, ladies and gentlemen. I don't know if this is true or not. I'm not reporting that it's real. But there are rumors that you might even get a Book of Boba Fett trailer today. And if we don't get it today, I feel like we're going to get it very, very soon. Maybe even next Monday or early next week or something like that. But some people really do think that that Book of Boba Fett trailer is coming today. That would be bananas. That would be nuts. And we would rush out of here and go do a reaction to that or something. Because holy cow, that trailer is going to be very, very hyped as well. So that's what we're going to get into today. We got a poll going on right now on if you are hyped for the Hawkeye show. It looks like 90% of you guys are hyped about the show. And what was interesting to me about this trailer, we were chatting it up a little bit on our Discord about it after the trailer dropped, and I was kind of working on the reaction video, etc., etc. We were talking about that, and I was surprised that some people were just like, you know, honestly, man, this trailer, it's okay. This trailer, it's kind of meh for me. You know what I mean? That's where some people are at with it. And I was like, well, you hate Christmas and you have no soul then. You know, look, we try to be very understanding and respectful to everybody's different beliefs, opinions, you know, whatever, you know, kind of stuff. We're very opening, you know, like arms open. You know, you feel this way about that way about this. It's all gravy, baby. It's all good. But one thing I will not abide is a lack of Christmas spirit here in Nerdvengers Tower. So you go get your ugly sweater. You go get a cup of cocoa. And you shut your mouth and you get into the Christmas spirit. Okay, here we go. Let's talk about the trailer. Let's go over it, and then we'll go over it together, just kind of breaking it down. But once
this is the first Christmas we've had together,
you know, let's get into the Christmas spirit, Stevie. If you're here watching, I think you are probably. Just let's get into this Christmas spirit.
Authorities are wondering if the masked vigilante who terrorized the city's underworld is back.
Oh no. He's having flashbacks to that moment. Look, we're only going to stop the trailer just for copyright issues. I think we'll be fine, but
I'll be home for Christmas. I promise.
I love this idea, this concept. I'll be home for Christmas, right? So many classic Christmas movies.
When I wore this suit, I made a whole lot of enemies.
Who are you?
You're Hawkeye.
Who the hell are you?
Some people have actually called me the world's greatest archer.
Are you one of those people? It's the most wonderful. Hey, babe, I should be back in a day or two.
So he's talking to his wife on the phone there. There were some people that were like, wait, is he not married? Or what's going on here? Yes, nah, that's his wife.
Things have gotten more complicated.
Yeah. And then people were like, is that Chris Evans? No, I don't think so, guys. I don't think that's Chris. Pizza Dog. You know what? We will probably get copyright. Now that I think about it, we probably will get copyright because of the song. No, Marvel, why'd you have to use the perfect song, the awesome Christmas song for this? No!
Definitely like that.
All right, let's keep going. I'll try to... We'll watch it without the music from here on out. Okay, so let's go over it again, and we'll put our own kind of music over the top of this. Now, look, I know there's a bunch of Grinches in here. You know what I mean? A bunch of Grinches in here that don't necessarily like Christmas and all that, right? So, I think for me... Like, first of all, like, let's just get this out of the way. Yeah, I like Christmas time a lot. It's, like, my favorite time of year. I get into the feels. I love visiting the fam. You know what I mean? I love Christmas. I love the vibes. I love everybody being in a better mood. And for me personally, last year was not it, man. Last year was not the Christmas I was looking for, as it were. It was weird. I didn't even go home, you know, because, obviously, Roni Rona. And a lot of just... weirdness to last Christmas. And it feels like, honestly, this year, even though, you know, in some ways things are still really, really crazy out there, this year we're at least going to have a more normal Christmas. And it feels like this show to me is kind of ringing in that vibe. And so the choice to make it, you know, basically a Christmas show, I mean, it's all over the marketing. There's even sort of snowflakes when you look at the the titling and whatnot. It is real. Look at this, like the snow there. It's a Christmas show. Like, they literally made a Christmas show. Okay, so that's number one for me, is just awesome and a very welcome, you know, vibe to the show. Okay, a very, very welcome feeling to it. I also just think that, you know, these two actors, the leads of the show, are pretty freaking incredible. You know, if you haven't really done a lot of rewatching of the MCU recently, I recommend you do it again and just keep an eye on Hawkeye, man. Because he's so important and so... He's very useful as a character in a lot of those movies. I mean, first of all, Age of Ultron, without him, you can't get to the core of what they were trying to do in that movie, right? And he's the one that has the family and the sort of normalcy to the side. You can't get there. There's a reason, I think, that he's the first character you see in Endgame. You know what I mean? The first character that loses his family, because we had connected to his family via Age of Ultron, etc., etc. He has these powerful moments with Wanda. You know what I mean? Where he's humanizing the whole thing. You know? He's a very, very important character to the Marvel Cinematic Universe. Even though it's like kind of a joke, and he's like, he's just an archer, he's just firing arrows, and even he sort of makes fun of himself in the Age of Ultron movie, right? Super, super important character. And I think it's awesome that we're getting a show with him as the main character, just in general. But the fact that it's also going to adopt one of the most fun comic book stories that I've ever read. And it came at a time when comics really needed, I'll make this big again, when comics really needed, like, something fresh, you know what I mean? That, to me, that 2012 Matt Fraction, David Aja run was really, really impactful. Just great cartooning. It had, like, a sort of nostalgic 9-panel grid, you know, grid system thing going on there. And just great writing. You know what I mean? Great writing. A lot of great moments in this run, in that comic book run. So that's kind of another big reason why, for me, I'm just like, man, they're really doing a lot to just bring in some warm cuddlies, some warm feelings for your boy. You know what I mean? I'm feeling nice and warm. Feels like home. You know what I mean? With this show. But all that sap in my kind of emotions aside, I also think that, you know, some of the things that are really, really exciting for the show, and some of you guys that are maybe not as into all that kind of stuff, there's a lot going on in this show. Okay, so we're getting a really good look at what the MCU currently looks like. You know what I mean? He's obviously got the hearing aids, and we think that might be because of just the battles in Endgame and just the craziness of Endgame. He's got the hearing aids. He is deaf, which is a big part of the whole Matt Fraction run, right? And you get Pizza Dog out of that. But it's also going to tie into Echo and some interesting things with the Echo character as well, right? the whole idea of the Ronin costume being really like central to what is going on, that would imply that she, and they sort of talk about it in the trailer, that Kate Bishop has sort of taken up the mantle of Ronin, and she's going around trying to stop the tracksuit mafia, or, you know, just in general bad guys. And the thing about that is that she's just way out of her depth, right? She's like super completely, unequivocally out of her depth, because that costume and like Hawkeye's, you know, not only just his prowess as a combatant, but also where that suit comes from and the history and lineage behind Ronin. It's a whole thing. You know what I mean? Like, it's a whole thing. And she's really stepped into something that she probably doesn't understand much at all. Okay? Now, that's going to bring in ties to history with Clint Barton, his history with the Ronin mantle, perhaps even some scenes. I mean, this was a long-standing rumor that we were going to see him in the Ronin suit again, cutting people down, doing katana-type craziness in the show. And it looks as though, yeah, man, we're going to get some more of that flavor, which is really, really cool. So there's a lot of interesting ties to that. Now, I see it in chat, and I see like a lot of you guys sort of asking about a couple of different things. Let's start with Yelena. You know what I mean? So this is kind of an interesting move. Yes, Yelena, at the end of Black Widow, one of the post-credit scenes, slight spoiler alert if you haven't seen it, is about Yelena coming to after Clint because she thinks that Clint is the one responsible for Natasha's death. Okay? So do we expect her to pop up into the show? Absolutely. Probably towards the back half of the show. And probably have something to do with the other really big surprise that is out there. And that is about Vincent D'Onofrio's Kingpin being in the show as well. Guys, as far as I know, that's very solid. It is a very solid story. You know what I mean? Like, they have images of this. And of course, they could rip it out. They could do whatever they want to do with Marvel. And they have ripped stuff out before, like of WandaVision and other things that left, you know, sort of scoopers or insiders holding the bag, as it were. But I don't think they're going to do that with Vincent D'Onofrio's Kingpin. Kingpin is going to be in episodes 5 and 6 of the show, as far as we understand it, okay? And he's going to be involved in the show, likely from the perspective of having something to do with the crime that's going on. Either he knows who's responsible for the tracksuit mafia, or he is in some way in charge of the tracksuit mafia, you know? If we remember from the Daredevil show, Kingpin was kind of pulling all the strings while not really being known as the main guy. That changes over time, but we could see something like that happening with D'Onofrio. I also think the fact that Echo will likely be in this show and be revealed to be the one that passed on the Ronin mantle to Clint and one of the people that helped train him, there could be some connection with Echo and Kingpin also. There's another really big rumor about this show that we don't fully know, you know, we don't know if this is true or not, but there's some rumors of even Charlie Cox, Daredevil, popping up in the show, and also a connection to Spider-Man. Yeah, I think, unless I'm mistaken, the show is going to have an episode the week that Spider-Man releases in theaters. And there will literally be a tie to Spider-Man in the Hawkeye show. And now that we've seen the Spider-Man trailer, doesn't that make a little bit more sense? If it's all over Times Square that Peter Parker is Spider-Man, if it's all over the news, don't you think Hawkeye would at least have some of that popping up in the show? You know what I mean? So we'll see, man. There's a lot of craziness and big stuff that is potentially being planned for the show. So just at face value, there's a lot of different reasons why I think this is going to be really, really fun. You know, but there's also a little bit of that juice. A little bit of that juice for the MCU stands out there. You know, everybody's all thirsty for the juice, as it were. So here's what we'll do. We will chat just a little bit and go over the trailer. So I know there's some super chats that came in. We'll do a little bit of that Q&A. But then I want to break off into some of the other things that are going on, talk a little bit about the Doctor Strange craziness that's going on out there. Put a one in the chat if you've heard the most recent crazy Doctor Strange rumors. Put a one into the chat because we're going to break that down. I want to do that in a full-fledged video for sure. So I'll do a video fully about that. But yeah, let's get into a little bit of the Q's and the A's. See what everybody's saying about the trailer. Oh, wait, there's one more thing I wanted to show you guys. Okay, look, this is slight spoilers. This is a confirmed picture of what Vincent D'Onofrio Kingpin is going to look like in the Hawkeye show. Don't sue me, Disney. Don't come after me. Look, here's what it is. I know. You're probably thinking the same thing that I'm thinking. Absolutely perfect. Perfect design. Perfect design. Incredible attention to detail. Comic book and cinema come together. Amazing. Absolutely amazing. I know. I can't believe we're so spoiled as Marvel fans, man. It's crazy. So, I didn't want to do that to you, but there you go. All right, let's do a little bit of this Q&A, man. Want to see what people are saying here. Terry Moto says, no, understand why Val was looking for Hawkeye because she thought he went back to assassinating people. Oh, now understand why Val was looking for Hawkeye because she thought he went back to assassinating people. I mean, that could be part of it for sure. I think, yeah, Val could be looking for him or her in that sense. A lot of people are saying, you know, Kate Bishop will likely be Young Avengers. And they'll do, you know, that sort of thing with it, which could be fun. But, yeah, that is an interesting thought. I appreciate the support, man. Thank you so much. Thanks for bringing that up. Big Stevie, Sir Grinch a lot. Yep. Says, my new name is Some People, LOL. Hey, thanks for the support, man. And also, thanks for all your bah humbugs, you mother trucker. Mike, MCU is your daddy Porter with a $2 holla says, I have a new name and slogan. Mike, what's the new name and slogan? Tell me in the chat. RF Gaming Channel with a $2 holla says, I need the neighborhood that calls him Hawkeye. Take my money. I know, right? Dude, that run, and like I said, at noon, we will read some of that comic with you guys. It is super fun. It is super fun. Mas with a $5 holla says, why are you hating on my heart? It's three sizes too small, okay? Bah humbug. Oh, looks like we got another. Look, you and Stevie can hang out on that side of the tower. You know what I mean? That side of Nerdvengers Tower this the end of this year. We'll have a big old Christmas tree in the tower, a nice, fun, festive thing. And then we'll have, like the butthole section or something. And we'll make sure that all the people in the tower are pointing over. When they see Stevie, when they see Mas, they'll be like, oh, nope, you go over there. You go over there, and we'll have maybe like a little dying Christmas tree like Peanuts did or something like that. That'd be fun. Darth Bayou says, definitely giving me Die Hard vibes. Watch is a Christmas movie. Which is a Christmas movie to all the haters. P.S. Take my money. Yeah, thanks so much for the support, brother. And I agree, Die Hard is definitely a Christmas movie. This had Die Hard vibes, John Hughes vibes to me. I don't know. You say what you will. Say what you will about the show. Maybe it didn't, you know, do it for you 100%. It's definitely not, like, the craziest, epic MCU show. It's not going to be on the level of Loki as far as bizarreness and connective tissue. It's probably not going to be as dark as Moon Knight or whatever, you know? Dude, this is a show. They won me over in this trailer. I'm quite excited for it. Grady Edwards with a $5 holla says, I really liked the trailer, but for a brief second, it felt like they were doing a full Netflix MCU tone. It feels like we're getting a mix of this in he? What? H-E? What? In he? Is that a Netflix show that maybe I'm not familiar with? But thanks for the love, Grady. Yeah, look, it does have a John Hughes vibe, man. It's got like a very... just good feeling vibe. But I'm telling, there's going to be some fun MCU stuff also sprinkled throughout this show. And again, I think maybe I just love that comic book run so much that I'm like, man, I feel like they're nailing the vibe of that. I feel like they're nailing the vibe of a Christmas movie. I'm here for it. You know what I mean? So, big Stevie Sir Grinch a lot. Jeez, man. What's his full name? Sir Grinch a lot W. Okay. Bah humbug with the black hearts. Yes. No, thanks. Thanks for that. Yeah. Thank you for that. Hope somebody, hope nobody gets you for the Secret Santa, you know, just have you open it up and be like, I'm not into this. I'm not feeling this. Kevin with the $5 houses, love how they are scheduling these Disney Plus shows. We still have What If, then Hawkeye, then to finish the year off with the Book of Boba Fett. Let's go. I know. And can you believe it? We're 9 days away from Star Wars Visions, dude. We're 9 days away from Star Wars Visions. So the content just keeps it rolling. And I'm excited. There's not a thing coming out for the rest of the year that I'm like iffy on. I'm a little bit like with, as far as Eternals goes, I'm interested to see how audiences respond to it. And I'm not as pumped for Eternals as I am for some of these other projects. But man, it's crazy. We've got so much fun, nerdy stuff coming for the back half of the year. It's going to be amazing. T-Love, a.k.a. the Silver Lurker, with a very generous $10 holla, says, I love Christmas. Stop. I love Christmas movies. Stop. Hawkeye looks kind of fun at best. Hard stop. Wait, what? Kind of fun at best? T-Love, no. Say it ain't so. You really had me in the first half of that message. I guess we'll just have to wait and see, won't we? I'm going to have to look at the chat. Is everybody raging? Is everybody like, you're too into it, Josh? Nobody's feeling it. You're the only one that really loves it. You're embarrassing yourself. It's super cringe. What are you doing? Dennis Shills. I'll check the chat in a second. Stormy says with a $5 holla, we know that swordsman in the series also, so we are probably getting his origin. Hopefully Trickshot shows up also, but man, can't wait for Fisk. Yeah, Trickshot would be fun too. That's his brother. That would be fun, man. And also possibly set up Dark Avengers. One of my favorite things to say on stream. Take your shot. Take your shot. All right, let's go over these next two super chats here. Then we'll talk about some of the other crazy news that's out there. Might be slightly spoilery for you guys. And so we'll get into that. And then we'll do just a little bit more Q&A. And then we'll get on out of here. Mike, MCU is your daddy Porter with a $5 holla, says, I'm the original MCU stan. How do you like my slogans? Like MCU rules and phase four or bust. My new slogan is MCU is your daddy. Mike. I love it, Mike. I love it. I can't. Man. Yeah. Loving it. Thanks for the support, brother. Pretty Nikki with a $5 holla says, Hawkeye. I tried to read it the way you typed it. So pumped. Can't wait. Shut up, Josh, and take my money. Thank you, Nikki. So sweet. Thank you so much for that. And yeah, I'm here for it. Now let's see what's going on in the chat. Is everybody mad at me because I like the trailer so much? Let's see. Let's see here. Josh, I hate your face. Stop being so happy. Josh, Christmas clearly sucks. You've lost your mind. Hashtag cancel Josh for not respecting other holidays. Okay, cool. Looks like a regular ass chat to me. Okay. Now. Oh, man, dude. The MCU woke. Oh, it's the best thing in the world. I'm so excited for the MCU wokeness. You know what I mean? The most woke, the most she. Give it all to me. In fact, are we sure that Jeremy Renner should even. Never mind. I'm not going to go too far. Okay, let's talk about some of the other things that are going on in the nerdy world, okay? It's going to be slightly spoilery. This is going to be slightly spoilery. So, stay at your own risk, I guess, of all the craziness that's coming out there. Some of this I'm going to cover in a full video, okay? Some of this, I'll never talk about it again. Okay, so here we go. So, this happened 4 days ago, actually, but it's very interesting, and I want to see what you guys think about it. You know what I mean? I really do. I want to know what you guys think about it. One of the rumors for Spider-Man No Way Home is that Andrew's Spider-Man is going to be pretty close to the same age he was in his series, okay? Pretty much the same age. But Toby is going to be a much older, at least several years older, version of his Peter Parker in Spider-Man. What do you guys think about that? I love it, okay? And one of the reasons I love it is because Toby's the OG, right? Toby's the OG Spider-Man. Doesn't it make sense and track that he should be the oldest? He's like Papa Spidey. He's the one that's been doing it the longest. You know what I mean? He might have some wisdom for the other homies. He might have gone through some things that they have not. You know? And the fact that Tom is like just barely been Spider-Man. Even, you know, he's gone to space. He's done all these crazy things and all that, right? But he's still really, really young. Really young. I think it makes perfect sense. It's like the youngest child is Tom. Duh. The middle child is Andrew, which, again, super meta, but makes a lot of sense. And then you got old man Toby. Get off my lawn, Toby. I'm excited, man. Right? Doesn't it make sense? I mean, he was already 30 years old in high school, so he should be pretty old by now in that universe. So that's something that had kind of been out there, but a lot of people were talking about it. It's pretty fun. Okay, so this is kind of interesting. We can now shift into this story here. Per the Hollywood Reporter editor, Matthew Belloni, maybe what he's saying is Belloni, the Eternals will receive an exclusive theatrical run. Okay, now this was technically announced before Shang-Chi's second weekend in the box office, but I think the weekend numbers for Shang-Chi were great, dude. Like, they were great. I think it's actually tracking better than Black Widow was, even if you include the Disney Plus numbers. And all of that without China as well, which is pretty interesting. So I think Shang-Chi is doing well. It still might not make as much overall as Black Widow. It might, and it could edge it out. But it's looking to be on track, on a very, very good track. You know what I mean? And we sort of joked about this before, but it feels like Shang-Chi didn't just save us from The Dweller in Darkness. He saved all these other movies and all these other stuff, man. You know what I mean? It's pretty interesting. It's pretty interesting. So you get an exclusive look at the new Zack Snyder film, Marvel's The Eternals, which I'm pretty, pretty excited about. That'll be fun. I don't even necessarily want to go over this. This is about the Squirrel Girl and the New Warriors or whatever. Like, whatever, bro. I'm not about that life. Here's more of that stuff that'll get us all in trouble, but it's totally real. Some Shang-Chi posters. Yo, okay. So can we talk about this? With the Venom 2 thing. In fact, here we go. I'm going to end this poll. I want to start a new poll. Are you upset that Venom 2 will only be 1.5 hours? You tell me. I'd like to know what y'all think. Are you upset about this? And as you're answering, now let me edumacate you. And I'm not 100% sure on this, okay? But people were mad that Venom 2 was only going to be 1.5 hours. From what I understand, it's 1.5 hours plus credits, which is exactly the same length that the original Venom was, right? It's like people are mad. What are you talking about? Yeah, this whole thing here, right? People were upset about this. So they were thinking that it's going to be even, like, less than that. As far as I understand, it came out and said, no, that's... It's 1 hour and 52 minutes. It's a big difference. Yeah. I don't know. From what I understand, this was actually faulty information. It's going to be 1.5 hours plus other movies. If it has 15 minutes of previews and it's about 1 hour movie, yeah, that would feel a little weird for me. But even then, it's like Venom 2. Right? Like, I'm just looking to have a good time, watch Carnage and Venom fight. You know, see if there's any connective tissue to the MCU or any teases of Venom coming into the MCU and hang out in that world a little bit more. You know, I like Eddie Brock and Venom's dynamic. It's funny. So, I don't know. I don't know. It looks like 40% of you are upset. 40% of you are mad. And you probably want more. Or maybe some of you are like, I want less. I don't even want the movie. I don't even want to be talking to you right now. I don't want to be fucking filming, doing this and all that and shit like that. You know what I mean? Okay. So, Doctor Strange in the Multiverse of Madness has wrapped, and it's wrapped its reshoots. But, you know what we got to talk about? You know what we got to talk about? We got to take a bit. There's a... Oh, snap! I didn't mean to put up this leaked photo of exactly what Kingpin will look like in the Hawkeye show. I didn't mean to put this actual 100% confirmed real photo up for you guys. My bad. Now. Oh, yeah, and I wanted to talk about this, too, because I mean, dude. Stevie, get your ass in the Christmas mood. Look at this poster. This poster doesn't do anything for you. Beautiful New York, beautiful Christmas vibes, a good dog. What else do you want, bruh? Anyway. Okay. Let's talk about this a little bit briefly here, okay? And again, we're going to get into this in a full video later because I got some theories, y'all. I got some theories. The basic idea here. What Lizzie Hill is reporting, and we do like Lizzie Hill. We think she's good. She's got good sources. She's talking about how she's uncovered that in this film, Benedict Cumberbatch's Doctor Strange in the Multiverse of Madness, Doctor Strange 2, he is going to be at a moment of conflict when it comes to Wanda and whether or not he should kill her to save the multiverse, or is he going to follow the Hippocratic oath that he made as a doctor, always trying to preserve life, right? Or is he going to kill her? Because he's going to be like, yo, this is definitely going to destroy the multiverse if I don't do this, right? It's wild. Okay, it's absolutely wild. It ties into a bunch of crazy things that we've been hearing about the film. It also feels to me, and I know some people have been talking about this on our Twitter, Real Films said this is very House of M. And it is. It feels very House of M. Because at the beginning of that movie, they're trying to decide whether or not they want to kill Wanda. She's so freaking powerful and she's messing with reality and time. Should they destroy her? And then, like, Pietro flies there to warn her, and then all this other crazy stuff happens, right? So, I don't know. Do you think he's going to kill her? Are we going to get the death of Wanda in this movie? What do you guys think? Oh, and Star Nerd says, get them likes up. Yeah, definitely get them likes up. I haven't even looked at the likes right now, but I'm disappointed. You know? Look, I know everybody's bah humbugging about Christmas. Everybody's bah humbugging about the awesome, fun, happy vibes that the MCU is trying to put out. I get it. You know? We're all a bunch of entitled, angry nerds. I get it. I understand it. But y'all about to really ruin my mood. Move your finger down. Then move it to the right. And then click the like button. Not that far. That's the dislike button. Bring it back. And click the like button. Feige said her story continues after the Multiverse of Madness. He did say that, didn't he? But is that after she dies? And then it's a different Wanda variant? Now I'm just distracted by my own eyebrows. I don't know. If she doesn't die, then they're screwed even more. I mean, I don't think they're going to be able to stop her from doing all this. It's going to be interesting, man. I'm starting to believe, and, you know, it's... I'm starting to believe that if they do it right, they could make WandaVision make more sense. And maybe I'd go easier on WandaVision. The end of WandaVision didn't do it for me. Didn't like it. But there's a chance it was a part of a long play. And there's a chance that things that are happening in the future will elevate things that happened in that show. Y'all remember episode seven? Where we see her and the Mind Stone, and there's that we're in the thing, you know? That shit was crazy. And I was like, mutants, you know what I mean? Like, come on, man. And then nothing. Well, maybe we'll get there. Maybe what's going to happen in this film is going to further explain that. Yeah. It's pretty crazy. Okay, I think that's pretty much everything that I wanted to go over as far as stories and updates and things like that. Again, not too much crazy Star Wars stuff, just rumors that Book of Boba stuff could be coming out. So we'll keep an eye on that. Of course, Marvel and Disney both announced a ton of movies. Over the weekend, they announced dates for a ton of movies coming up. Marvel's going to have four movies in 2023, or maybe five movies in 2023. A lot of freaking movies in 2023. And then they've got a bunch coming in 2024 as well. So it's like nuts, guys. Like the amount of stuff that's going to be coming out in the next couple of years. I still contest that originally there was going to be a Battle World type Secret Wars play in 2024. And I think that is now probably moved to 2025. But I still believe that. I still believe that. And I know some people are like, it's way too soon, blah, 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 blah. Nah, son. I still believe it. I still feel like it's coming. Star Wars has a bunch of, you know, new dates for their films. The one that really interests me is the 2027 date. That will be the 50th year anniversary of Star Wars, the creation of Star Wars. And so, you know, some people were like, hey, do you think that the rumored sequel trilogy thing that Dude Trust Me Bro started, do you think that could be coming there? Maybe. Either way, I expect it to be a big deal. If whatever they're doing that year should slap. You know what I mean? It should have a major impact for the Star Wars fandom. So 2027, I know, 6 years away from now. I think that feels like an eternity. It'll fly. It'll fly by. You know what I mean? But yeah. Okay. Let's get into the Q and the A, guys. This stream is brought to you by the Nerdvenger members. You see all the people in the chat with the beautiful badge next to their name showing off that swag? Yeah, those are the Nerdvenger members. They keep the lights on here at Nerdvenger's Tower. There's a $5 a month tier. There is a $10 a month tier. And a lot of cool goodies go to the people that support us at that level because it legitimately helps us out in this crazy YouTube world. So thank you guys for all the support. And again, for you Nerdvenger members, at noon today, we're going to go live, members only. I want to talk about the Discord, and I want to read some of this Matt Fraction comic book with you guys because I love that story. So come on by for that if you are a Nerdvenger member, and we appreciate the support from everybody. Okay, here we go. Thanos Army, that's a pretty cool name, says with a 40 rupees, hi, sir. Love from India. Just uploaded reaction. Please shout out. Thanos Army. There's your shout out, bud. I like the name. Everybody go check out his reaction video. Blow it up. Put Nerdvengers in the chat. Just be like, yo, Nerdvengers, we're here. What up, Thanos Army? Much love. Or don't if you're Steve and you hate all the good things in life. Zoe says with the 1017... Freaking $5 holla, my brain not working. I think us fans deserve credit for Kate Bishop casting with all the fan casting we did. That's true. That's very true, Zoe. I'm so hyped. Let's fucking go. Take my money. Thanks, brother. And honestly, you're right. That was a big, big push for the fans. There was a lot of sort of back and forth because I think Haley had an Apple TV show and there was some debate on whether or not she'd actually sign to be Kate Bishop. She did sign. It's huge. I know people love Haley. I'm not the hugest fan of her, just being real. You know what I mean? And not because I'm just not familiar with her work, right? I get it. You know what I mean? And she's done a lot and her music and shit. Like, she was on a track with Logic that I really, really liked, but I'm a Logic fan. I'm not really a Haley fan. You know what I mean? So, a lot of people are super hyped up about that. And I think that's dope, man. So, that's awesome. And yeah, fans deserve credit. Grady Edwards with a $5 holla says, would you say Daredevil is for sure confirmed to be in No Way Home? Also, if when these characters return, is this a continuation slash soft reboot? Great couple of questions there. So I wouldn't say confirm because they could always change things, right? Like, look at what happened with WandaVision. Doctor Strange was supposed to be in that show, dude. Doctor Strange was supposed to be in that show. They cut him out, okay? So confirmed, I can't say that for sure. I will tell you, with all the powers of deductive reasoning that I have, I will tell you the odds on him being in the film, like 99%. I wouldn't say 100% because, again, they can change things. But, yeah, I think he's definitely going to be in the movie. When these characters return, is it a continuation slash soft reboot? I think it's a little bit of both. I think you will come to learn the MCU version, and they may actually reference some things that happened to them in the past that might loosely resemble what we experienced during the Netflix shows. One example of this, and I don't know if this is true, this is just something I heard, is that Daredevil will be in the yellow and red suit, okay? And apparently, one of the reasons he might have changed into that suit is because Bullseye got in the red Daredevil suit and caused a bunch of crazy chaos and made Daredevil look really bad. Pretty interesting. Also might explain why Matt Murdock would be enticed to help someone out like Peter Parker, having some, I guess, empathy for his situation because of the situation that he went through. So I'd say it's probably going to be something like that, but time will tell us, brother. That's my best guess with everything I know. Ari says with a $5 holla, having not seen Shang-Chi before, no Disney Plus, not only one, now have so much less interest and intrigue in the movie and nerdy content in general. Hashtag same day. Not having seen Shang-Chi, no Disney Plus, not only one. Okay, yeah. So I think what Ari is saying is he's not as hyped as Shang-Chi, about Shang-Chi as other people, and he feels like it's got to be same day and date because he wasn't even able to see it. I know Boss Logic, who lives in Melbourne, Australia, he was talking about how he can't even watch it. They can't even watch it in Australia yet, you know? So, yeah, look, I am still team streaming. I'm still team that's the way all of this is going. I did have a good time in the theater the last time I saw Shang-Chi. I like the theater experience. I just personally am like, nah, man, like, I want convenience. I'd rather have it faster. I'd rather be able to watch it at home. I like the movie theater experience, but I want to go to the movie theater to, like, watch the original Star Wars if I want to rent out a theater and have that experience, or go through the Matrix trilogy in a theater or something. Like, there's still a place for that experience. For me, I've just personally changed my sort of taste and what brings me value as a fan, right? And because I just sit in front of the computer all day like Jabba Josh. By the way, where's the fan art of Jabba Josh? I'm upset that that doesn't exist. Big Stevie, Sir Grinch-a-Lot, W, says, I'm just greedy and want as much venom as I can get with a $5 holler. Hey, nothing wrong with that. Nothing wrong with that, my friend. I think you'll get a plenty of venom. Hopefully, because I'm in the same boat. I want a lot of venom. Dang, you're right. Now I'm going to vote in the poll and say I am upset. Jensen Baker with a $10 holla, very generous, says, I'm excited for Hawkeye Christmas, and I only am worried about the Carnage runtime because I am used to having more time for story. If they only needed an hour and a half, it's all good. Yeah, that's fair, and we'll see. Maybe it'll feel like it was gutted. Maybe it'll just feel like a totally fun ride. There have been really long movies, a la the Snyder Cut, that to me feel shorter when you watch them because they're just incredibly well paced, and then there are movies that are really short that feel like an agonizing amount of time because they are horrible. So we'll just see, man, but I get the concern. Jedi Willis with a $5 holla, no message, but you followed up up here with a $10 holla, very generous, says, forgot to add a message on my first super chat. I love how different all your Marvel movies and TV shows are. It keeps things new and fun. You're awesome, man. Keep up the amazing work. Hey, thank you so much, Willis. I appreciate that. And yeah, they have so much going on right now. They're doing a Christmas freaking show, you know? And it's going to feel dope. It's going to have connective tissue. It's going to be awesome. The What If show is its own kind of thing. Loki was its own kind of thing. WandaVision was its own kind of thing, right? Think about all the people that love WandaVision because of, like, the Ed Sullivan shit and just, like, old television and just that kind of a vibe. So, yeah, they're able to do a lot with Marvel. It's like an evergreen brand at this point. You know, it's a lifestyle brand. And, dude, it's crazy. I never would have thought. I mean, back in the day, Marvel was fun, but it wasn't like this. Like, dude, it is a massive, massive lifestyle brand that has taken over a lot of different people's lives in different ways. It's fascinating to watch, even from a business perspective. You know what I mean? Like, maybe you're not feeling the MCU. Maybe you don't like it the same way other people do. You got to respect it from a business perspective. It's crazy what they're doing. Matthew K with a $10 holla says, I'd never thought I'd be the guy saying shh at the movie theater. But damn, kids these days can't bleep the heck away. Should be able to bring headphones into the theater and plug right into the audio. Bro, I know, right? You can control that shit at home with your OLED. That's all I'm saying. You can control that shit at home with your OLED TV and your fancy sound bar. Woo! That's what it's about. But yeah, no, I... Even in the second time we saw Shang-Chi, some, like, family came in towards the end and was, like, looking for someone. And they just literally come into the theater and they're like, where are they at? Where are they at? And I'm like, I'm not trying to hear you right now. I'm trying to hear the crazy, awesome action. Get the fuck out of here. You know what I mean? You can't control people at the theater. It's part of the reason why I think the experience has eroded, for sure. Nick D's Nuts Daris. Damn. Funny name. With a $5 holler says, hey, man. Thanks for the lightsaber knighting. That was awesome. My question is, what do you think the Young Avenger roster will be like in the MCU? Spider-Man? Thank you, Nick. And I was very happy to knight you with the saber, my friend. What do I think the Young Avengers is going to be like? Apparently, the Young Avengers is a big, big play for Marvel. A big, big play. I don't know how it's going to tie into all of this stuff. I hope they go with the Iron Lad story. One would expect that whatever happens in Multiverse of Madness with Wanda and her kids, that's the way to bring the kids back. Young Loki is apparently getting some more work, so maybe he'll come back. Kate Bishop. Spider-Man would be a good play, but why not do Miles? Why not intro Miles and have him hang out with the Young Avengers? I think that would be fun. And then maybe Stature, you know, in the Quantum Mania. Quantum Mania could be setting that up. So that's kind of some thoughts I have on it. But again, thank you for the love. Appreciate it. Appreciate the love tonight. Let's see here. Golden Hercules with a $5 holla says, Josh, did you see Carnage is the level 100 skin in the new Fortnite season? I foresee you getting carried in the near future now. Take my money. I did not see that. So wait a minute. What the heck? So you got to get to level 100 in the battle pass? Bro, that shit will never happen. I'm just saying, that shit will never happen. I like Fortnite. But I can't play, like, I can't play that much Fortnite, you know? Like, Fortnite's cool, but, like, bruh. 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 I don't know about all that, bruh. You know what I mean? Like, bruh. Bruh. Hang on. Did I miss a chat? Oh, 34 Virgo. It looks like I missed your super chat. My bad, bro. $10 holler here says, yo, Josh, I slept on the Hawkeye show. Trailer being good. It looks fun, fun, fun. Also, put a one into the chat if you Nerdvengers want me to play the Eagle song at the end of the stream today. Yeah, maybe we'll do an Eagle song as we ride out. Maybe we'll do Eagle song on the Nerdvengers stream when we come into that. That'd be kind of fun. So, yeah, no, appreciate the love, man. Yeah, dude, don't sleep on Hawkeye. I'm telling you, it's going to be fun, dude. It's going to be fun. It's going to be cool. It's going to be impactful. All you MCU fans that are like, but is Thanos going to show up and punch Kingpin in the banana? Duh. Duh. Dude, that would be amazing. If somebody carried me the whole way to the Carnage skin, I'd be here for it, but dang, bro. That would be so wild. That's a lot of carrying. It's a lot of carrying. That's all I'm going to say. Let's see here. I think I got to these other super chats, yeah? Yeah. I think I got to them. Okay, cool. So we're going to get out of here in just a second, guys. I'm going to hang and chat for just a little bit longer, and then we'll get out of here. Again, if you're a Nerdvenger member, look at the community tab and then the Discord, and we will be going live at noon. We're going to read some of this comic book. I'll talk a little bit about my ideas for the Discord. I put a little video in there earlier, but I want to talk with you guys about it together, and so we'll do that today as well. John White says, "Bah humbug, I hope your OLED cracks." I hope your OLED cracks and you have to go to the theater for everything for the rest of the year. And there's a gaggle of crying babies. Oh, no. Well, look, I'm forced to go to the freaking theater anyway. Now, you know, I'm forced to go to the theater anyways. You know, in a couple of weeks, I'm going to go for Venom 2, which I'm excited for. Better not be only an hour and a half, though. Then a couple of weeks after that, we got Eternals, right? Then you got, dude, then you got your Spider-Mans, you know? You got your Spider-Mans. Come on, man. You know, after Spider-Man into the next year, I think, what is it, March or something? We get in the Multiverse of Madness. Multiverse of Madness is going to be, like, did you guys see, and I'm going to put more of this in the video, but, like, Benedict Cumberbatch it was kind of saying, like, yeah, Spider-Man's cool, but when Multiverse of Madness comes out, it's going to blow everyone's hair back, and they're going to be like, no, this is the craziest comic book movie ever. Have a seat, Spider-Man movie. Doc Strange about to show y'all how it's done. That's what we're hearing. John White with a $5 holler says, just kidding. Please don't ban me. I love the show. Stop the ban on John. Yeah, he's cool. No, Stevie, you can... Yeah. No, actually, we can't do Stevie. He gives way too much money. You can't ban him. I know he's got so much nerd coin. I know. Anyway. Jensen Baker with a $2 holler says, whatever happened to the Bumblebee sequel? That's a good question. Oh, was Steinfeld... Haley was in that as well? Right? Yeah, I don't remember. Did I see the Green Knight yet? Joe Merrill asked. I have seen the Green Knight. You know, look, I liked the movie. I thought it was cool and interesting. Elisa hated it. My girlfriend hated it, bro. Because it's like a very slow, kind of trippy, you know, kind of movie. Yeah. So it was fun, but it wasn't, I don't know. I'll probably never watch it again. You know what I mean? There was some really fun, like, fantasy elements to it. And there was some trippy shit, too. But, like, man, I could have used this a little action. There was literally, like, none. You know, spoiler alert for the movie. There's no action. There's none. Like, zero. No fighting. Oh, you thought all this fun, fantasy, dope fighting shit was going to happen? Nope. So. Dorian Trussell with a $10 holler says, Hawkeye is really epic. All hyped up. Excelsior! Boromir, one does not simply walk into Mordor. Or the MCU. Kate Bishop will be excellent character to explore in the MCU. Yeah, man. Yeah, I'm excited. Thank you, man. Thank you for the support. Much love. One does not simply walk into the MCU, Kate Bishop. You're going to learn today. You're going to learn today. Yeah. Garrett says, barely caught the stream. Hey, it's all good, man. As long as you catch it. You know, you can fumble it a little bit. You got to catch it. You got to get 2 feet down in bounds. Wasn't sure how much I liked it while I was watching it, but the end tied it all together. You talking about the Green Knight, Mosmos? That's fair. The end ties it all together. I thought it was interesting, to say the least. Very interesting, but no action. Just makes me want the Lord of the Rings show now? Yeah, for sure, man. Yeah, dude. Yeah, the Green Knight was pretty slow. It was pretty slow, I must admit. Slow is fine with beautiful cinematography. I tend to agree. Not everybody does, though, you know. Everybody has different feelings about this, yeah. That's fair, Mosmos. That's an interesting take. I'm sad you're going through Premier Access withdrawal. I know, man. Ugh. Why can't I just have everything I want in front of me all the time? I'm just lying around here like Jabba Josh, you know what I mean? I just lie around like, put on the OLED. Get me Chick-fil-A and put on the OLED. That's what I'd like to be doing, but instead I have to, like, move around and go to the theater and stuff. Do we know when The Boys is coming back? I don't think we do, bro. I don't know if we do. No, Dot. I don't know if we do. All right, everybody. I'm going to get on out of here. Thank you guys so much for the love, for the support, for chiming in. And we will be chatting at noon for the NerdVenger members today. And also, I know there's still some like NerdCoin transfers that I need to work on. Renee, I know I still need to send you the NFT on Vivi. I'm going to be knocking out a bunch of that stuff today as well. So I'm into it. Am I hyped for the House of the Dragon? We'll see. The ending of Game of Thrones really, really upset me. So we'll see. We'll see. All right, everybody. Much love. Much love. See you guys. See the members at noon. And I'll see the rest of you later, man. As I always say, I hope you're having an awesome and a nerdy day. And I'll see you in the next video. Eagle song, little eagle song. Much love, much love. That's all I really got on this one, guys. I just want to say, about to hop on one of these Eagles and fly to Chick-fil-A myself, you know. They might feel a little bit weird as I order a chicken sandwich. It's the circle of life and all that shit. Yeah, yeah. Okay. Goodbye, everybody.